to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I surrender all to you, everything I give to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing.
Come on, you say.
John 3:16, Romans 5:8, and 1 John 4:15. Thank you, King. King, Stacy. Yes. 1 John 4:7-11. You had us, amen. You can remain seated. Amen. This morning, we just bless God. God is good to us.
Yes, He is.
How many love Jesus?
Amen.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
That he gave his only begotten Son.
That he gave his only begotten Son.
That whosoever believeth in him.
That whosoever, that's anybody, that believeth in him.
Should not perish.
Should not perish.
But have everlasting life.
But have everlasting life. And the church said,
amen.
Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor. Non-returnable love.
Amen.
You can't love God more than he loves us. It's non-returnable. You know, if you have a envelope that says that you can't forward it, that means it's going back to the sender. That's the way the post office had it designed. And you know, sometimes the sender tried to outsmart the post office. Mm-hmm. I have any smart elves in here trying to outsmart the post office? Don't put a return address on it. You know, it's a federal offense to open the mail. Mm-hmm. And so if you don't put another postage on it, you don't put a return address on it, you would think that the letter would go to the sender. Well, the letter will go to the sender. But when the sender gets the letter, there's a fee. They have to pay for the rest of the postage. Come on, somebody on.
Yes.
There's no slick way about it. Now, if that's your bill, you trying to get your bill paid, and your bill company they're gonna charge the bill company to get your check out of that envelope. Mm. The bill company is not gonna accept it.
Mm. Amen.
Somebody help me in this
place. Amen.
And so it's almost like a catch-22. Well, something gotta happen. What happens in instances like that? My understanding, I don't know, Frazier, you might help me, but I believe the U.S. Postmaster have the authority to open the mail.
Amen. That's correct.
Yes.
See where the mail came from.
Ah.
And they'll send the mail back to you.
Yes.
But it won't go to wherever it's supposed to go. I looked at that and said, okay, that's one aspect of non-returnable. But at the same time, they send it back. There's a way around it so that they can send it back still. And then I looked at my trade as an engineer. And as we operate boilers, depending on the size of the boiler, and I just pretty much think about a high pressure boiler, there's types of boilers that generates so much pressure that some kind of way it have to have a way of relieving that pressure. And when that boiler generates so much pressure in it, it could actually blow up.
Okay.
So the object of whoever was ingenious in developing a valve called a non-returnable valve. And this valve, it's when this boiler is running and generates so much pressure, the pressure that's in that boiler lifts that valve up. And then the steam goes out of that boiler and do the work. If this boiler right here is not running, its valve is closed. And as the steam go up, it pushes on the valve trying to get in to this boiler. But because this boiler here have a non-returnable valve on it, steam can't go in from here to here. Steam got to go on the way it's supposed to go. Y'all got the picture?
Yeah.
I'm trying to paint the picture. I wish I had somebody help me. See me. But if this boiler comes on while this boiler is online, this boiler will run and generate enough pressure. And the pressure that it generates has to overcome the pressure that's already been run on this boiler. Because this boiler is leading. Somebody help me here. And sometimes when you lead, you're going to find yourself getting under certain types of pressure. Yes, you are. And when the pressure comes, amen, it seems like it's trying to bust your head wide open. I wish I had somebody been in the pressure cooker that had been under some real stress or some real pressure. It'll bust your brain wide open. Yes, it will. It will. Amen. Amen. And what it'll do is it'll cause stuff to explode. Stress. Amen. Everything else. But they have it designed so that once this pressure in here, or this pressure in here, this pressure right here, this pressure out of this boiler has to begin to be greater than this pressure to just to get online. Y'all help me, somebody.
Amen.
And if we keep having these 29 degree days outside, both boilers will run.
Amen.
Because it's going to be a demand. Somebody say demand.
Demand.
And when there's a demand, amen, the steam will go and it'll supply, it'll do. And if there's not enough coming out of here, this ball right here will come and back it up. I wish I had somebody help me here. I'm just talking still about non-return. Yeah. Amen. And the object is on those valves and how they, it's not like somebody's up there on top of the ball and turning the valves, turning them here, turning them there. Can you think about God? He loved us so much.
I know.
That he sent his love to us, that we can never love him so much, that his love, our love can go back to him. No matter what you do and show God your love, it's nothing compared to what he's going to send to us. His love will always supersede whatever we can do. Somebody help me here. And so if I know that, and I know
but God commended his love towards us.
God, he commended, he gave his love, sent his love, he gave his love to us, yes.
And that while we were yet sinners.
God loves us when we were in our mess. I wish I had some messy folks in there that could testify.
Amen.
One day we need to go back to have just a testimony show.
Amen.
Testimony service is talking about the mess that God had brought you out of.
Amen.
It's not to glorify the devil.
Amen.
I'm going to make this clear. Because sometimes we think that, you know, we're going to give God glory, but we glorify the devil. Talk about what the devil is doing. We ain't talking about what the devil is doing. We got to talk about what God has done. God loves us when we messed up.
Yes.
See, we sometimes if you think about it, amen, and think about what God brought us from, God brought us from a mighty long way. And when God brings you out, you can't forget where he brought you from.
Amen.
Don't you forget where God delivered you from.
Amen.
Sometimes we get so high and mighty, you know, God raises us up, and we become preachers, and we become good drummers, and good keyboard, and we become, you know, all this in God. And after we become all this in God, we forget, we act like the folks come in. Amen. And they come in, they come to church, and they all messed up and jacked up. We forget where God brought us from.
While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
He died for us when we were messed up. We can't overcome that. Come on, read.
Verse 9.
Go. First John.
1 John chapter 4.
I wanted to use some scriptures this morning because, you know, when we talk about love, we always talk about, you know, agape love, and then we talk about philia love, and we talk, you know, surrogate, and we talk about the various types of love. Amen. And we don't realize God loves us unconditionally.
Amen.
He loves us whether we love, amen, our brothers and sisters or not.
Yes.
We got an assignment, amen, coming up, amen. We're not going to have Bible class this Thursday because Dr. Pettis is coming Friday. But next Thursday, amen, the following Thursday, we're going to be right back here. We have an assignment, and the assignment is to read about Cain and Abel.
Yeah,
and about the son. Amen. Read those two Bible stories. Amen. You need to read them. And if you don't come to Bible class, shame on you. Look at your name and say, shame on you.
Shame on you.
Shame on you. I'm getting on folks that don't come to Bible class. Shame on you. You go through hell and you wonder why you can't get delivered because you don't come to Bible class.
That's
I heard a preacher say, God ain't going to send you to hell for that. And I'm telling you, God ain't going to send you to hell for nothing. You're going to send yourself to hell. You don't know how to get out of this trap that the devil set before you.
Jesus.
Now people talk all this crazy talk, but if you walk around and you step in a bad trap, and the bad trap catch you, so help me.
Amen.
You trap. You trap. You stuck. And you can't go nowhere until you get released from that trap.
Right.
I wish I had somebody to know what I'm talking about. Had some shackles on their feet. Good day. But when you get yourself in a situation that only God can bring you out, you shouldn't bother that stuff up and don't tell nobody.
Amen.
We shouldn't get to the place and take the posture, take the position that we saved and we're ready to go to heaven. That's not what we saved for. You saved for you be here on earth.
Amen.
You need salvation to go to heaven. But you all shouldn't be getting saved just to get to heaven.
Right.
Somebody help me. You ought to be doing some work.
Amen.
Somebody say, what kind of work? I need to tell somebody, God deliver me, and he'll deliver you.
Yes. Amen.
God
Amen.
Brought me out, he'll bring you out.
Amen.
It's hard on my children when I talk about what God did for me. It's hard on them because they got to hit my dad up there talking about himself. Like he, you know, he shouldn't tell everybody. He shouldn't tell everybody all the stuff that he done. I can't tell you everything I've done. You probably wouldn't stay here and be here if I'd be a pastor.
Amen.
If I tell you everything I've done. But if you tell us everything you've done, we probably won't mess with you. Come on, Miss Mom. Come help me this way. Come to all of us got our mess.
Yeah.
And Paul came to him, tell us, and once such as us, such, we were such like one of them. And when what Paul was talking about, he talking about the prostitute. Somebody help me.
Yeah.
I said, dude, that's where we're going. Yeah. Why? Because somebody stopped showing up.
Right.
Didn't mean that they didn't have it.
Right.
Didn't mean that they didn't get the teaching.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody help me in this place.
Amen.
Amen. But we're getting in Bible class. But let me tell you what I thought about. I thought about the love, how God loved me. He loved me unconditionally. He loved me when I was messed up.
Amen.
He loved me, amen, when I'm doing right. He loved me when I'm doing wrong. We can't override God's love.
Yeah.
Somebody said, well, I can negate God's love. You can't negate God's love.
Yeah.
Somebody help me. You can suffer the consequences of your wrong action and your wrong doing,
yeah,
but you can't negate God's love. He still loves you.
Yeah.
I'm still in John.
Yeah. 1 John chapter 4, starting in verse 7.
Uh-huh.
Beloved. Let us love one another.
Listen, let us. Somebody say us.
Us.
Uh-huh. Let us love one another. Mm-hmm.
For love is of God.
Okay. If you say that you can't love folks, you're not of God. Let me see. Wait a minute. Ain't no mean folks over there. Let me wait a minute. I'm trying to find the mean.
And
when they brought you back to the altar, you didn't get on the altar and go to sleep.
No.
Not get on the altar, we go on to sleep. And it's over with, you know, hey, I'll wake up now, prayer be over. When you come to prayer, you need to get on fire with God. You need to get in touch with Him.
Yes.
You need to talk to Him. You need to listen to Him. Somebody help me here.
Yes.
You need to respond and praise Him.
Yes.
You need to talk to Him.
Yes.
You need to listen to Him.
Yes.
And you need to respond and praise Him.
Yes.
You need to talk to Him.
Yes, sir.
You need to listen to Him.
Yes.
And you need to respond by praise Him.
Because that God sent His only begotten Son into the
world. Oh, back in 3:16. Come on, read. Say it again. Read. Well, your hand. Okay. I'm done. Okay. When the audio was put the hand on the screen, I couldn't see. Come on, read.
God has sent His only begotten Son into the world.
Uh-huh.
That we might live through Him.
Yeah.
Verse 10. Herein is love.
Wait. Verse 1.
Verse 10.
Uh-huh.
John.
Yeah.
Herein is love. Not that we love God, but that He loved us and sent His Son to be the propitiation for our sins.
Listen. God loved us so much that He sent His Son, Jesus.
Yes.
And Jesus came here on earth, amen, to die for our sins.
Yes.
He was our sacrifice.
Right. Yes.
He's now our lawyer.
Yes.
He used that word propitiation. Amen. That means He's my advocate.
Yes.
He's my lawyer. Mm-hmm. And He's my mouthpiece.
Yes, Lord.
He's all of those kind of things.
Mm.
Somebody said, well, I thought God came to earth. He did. But if you know anything about the scripture, God is a spirit.
Yeah.
And they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth.
Yeah.
Come on. And if you know anything about God, He's invisible.
Yeah.
Spirit is invisible. And if you know about Jesus, Jesus came in the flesh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So Jesus is the manifestation of God in the flesh.
Yeah.
Jesus, amen, is the manifestation of the invisible God.
Yeah.
It's the invisible God that's been made visible. Somebody help me in the prayer. And when the invisible God had become made visible, amen, amen, when Jesus, amen, went back to heaven, He sent back some invisible for us. Somebody help me in this way, which is the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Yes. Now the Holy Spirit is just as much God as God is.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
sir. It is just God. Amen. It is just Jesus made back invisible as in us. So in us, amen, we have the love of God. In us, we have God. In us, we have the fullness of God.
Yes.
Amen. In the Godhead body. Come on. In Jesus, if it's in Him, it's in us.
Yes.
If you go, amen, near some radiation, amen, although the radiation may be in whatever it's in, amen, when it gets in you, it's just as much radiation in you as it is in that stuff that is in.
Amen.
Oh, God. Love. Come on, read it.
Verse 11.
Uh-huh.
Beloved. If God so loved us.
If God so loved us.
We are also to love one another.
Uh-huh. Tell your neighbor, I need to love you.
I need to love you. I need to love
you. And this is the test. You have to love those folks that you don't like.
That's right.
Good God. How many people hear that come out of my mouth? Love folks I don't like.
Amen.
You turned me off.
Yep.
I'll turn a lot of church out. I'm trying to see you there. But the Bible tells us love our enemies. Love them that hate you.
Yes.
Pray and persecute you. Pray for them that despite you.
Yes.
Come Now, don't nobody say nothing, that way we won't know it's you. When somebody do something wrong to you, don't that get on your nerve, don't ask. Don't ask. That this Bob used to know me.
Yes, right.
Right? And you don't even think about loving them.
Why?
Have you figured out why?
No.
The devil don't want you to love him.
Why?
He wants you to be constantly mad at him.
Yes, sir.
And the more you're mad at him, the less you will be effective for God.
You talking good, bro.
Because if you're mad at him, you're going to have iniquity in your heart. And the Bible says, if I draw iniquity in my heart, God don't hear me when I pray. Necessarily just have to avoid them. They come into me and I go that way. You don't love them when you do that. That's not love. Love is when I say, hey, I ain't gonna help that. Good to see you this morning. You know, and go about my business. We ain't gotta have a long conversation.
That's right.
We don't have to get into no dialogue.
That's right.
Show me the ladies. You ain't never gonna have to do all that. Huh? But you gotta be cordial to your enemy.
Yes.
See, you can allow your enemy to take care. I wish I had somebody help me in this way. If you don't understand, amen, the scripture, Mephibosheth, amen, was the enemy, but he found himself sitting at the table of David.
Yeah.
Because David had genuine love for that young man.
Amen.
And when you have genuine love, people will take care of you. People will give you money that you never thought they would give you money. But you got to personalize this thing.
Amen.
We got to stop getting in the group and start individualize this thing, bring it to ourselves. God loved me.
Yes.
He so loved me.
Jesus.
That he sent Jesus to die for me. Amen. And if I paraphrase the passage, I put it this way. God loved me so much he got up off the throne and came down and died for me.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
You are.
to you withholding nothing, withholding nothing.